The way the Hurricanes have scored some tries tonight.
It is a try!
Hello, Lele. My name is Loni Uhila, aka the Tongan Beard.
Fatialofa lover. My name is Iopu Iopu-Aso, aka Clark King.
Pula Vinaka. My name is Michael Fatialofa, aka Uncle Bully. Bully.
And we are the Hurricanes. Woo-hoo!
That's right. We're never going to give you the blues because we're always happy.
Yeah.
But we're always going to be fresh. Boom, bullet. Peace. Boom.
Coming up on today's show, fresh tips and tricks on what to take to a Palagi guy's house for dinner.
Tip number one when a Palagi invites you to dinner is to always eat beforehand. Why is that?
Because they'll never have enough food, ever.
And Aunty Tala gave us more fresh advice.
Don't make me twerk over here. This tool will disappear.
Oh no, I've never seen it, this thing.
Oh, you know, it's like that, yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah, that's how I twerk.
Wow.
Yeah.
Can we check out more islanders worldwide with a Poly Postcard?
Coming up, I'm going to show you the beautiful Argentina.
What are we doing here?
And right now,
we're keeping it fresh with the new out-of-the-box newcomers.
Valkyrie and Samoan sister Lavina Williams. Keep it fresh, baby girl.
We must have been together. I bet you knew just
Hello, Falava Fresh. I'm Lavina Williams.
I'm Andrew Williams.
Welcome to Big AM. Welcome to Big AM. Let's go check it out.
Come here. Be in it, and you're going to be in it. The answer's a question there, brown sugar. Brown sugar.
Brown sugar.
What is the freshest thing about the big gay out?
You.
That freshest thing?
Lava lovers.
The lava lovers. That's the freshest thing.
I think it's grown a lot over the last few years, which is really good. It shows how much support the community has. And also how many straight people are here. That's cool, right?
Kia ora, what's up everybody? We are Valkyrie. We get asked, oh, Sue goes to reggae, and we're like, no. And they're like, oh, hip hop, and we're like, no. And they're like, Palagi music, and we're like, yeah.
Yes,
that's us. With me, I'm a runaway child. It's nice to be brown and do something just slightly different. Enjoy the rest of your day and make sure you check us out.
Keep it fresh.
Keep it fresh.
Yes.
Keep it fresh.
Light strikes upon, yes, and the sun begins to fade.
What are you looking forward to the most today?
Yeah.
I'm looking for the queens. Drag queens. Come entertain me.
Supported the gay community. They've always supported me during my journey, my music journey. So I decided this year, yes, I will come back and I will sing with my people.
Happy Big Gay Out.
The freshest thing about being here at the Big Gay Out is living your truth. That's how we do it.
Like really, we are all the same. We're human beings. And all we've got to do is chase some love.
I'm here because I'm who I am. I'm enjoying myself.
We love brown sugar.
Oh, right.
One, two, three, four.
Wait, hold on. Look at me. When you throw your bunch, you gotta use your legs. You gotta bring your whole weight to the other side. Bang. You see me? Yeah, can you see me? And that's your fresh tip and tricks. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Tip number one when a Palagi invites you to dinner is to always eat beforehand. Why is that?
Because they'll never have enough food, ever. There's a big difference between Palagi portions. There's a big difference between Palagi portions. There is a big difference between Palagi portions and Polynesian portions. Two different worlds.
It's important that you remember the portion sizes.
Size counts in this case. Okay, always eat beforehand. Yeah, here's another one. Don't eat with your hands.
Very important. They have this thing on the other side of the plate, it's called cutlery. Unless your friend is Indian and that's how they eat,
that hand.
Don't you eat with your hands. But if you must eat with your hands, I'd say eat with your hands just to mess with them.
Bruh.
Just make them ask the question. You can always come up with some culture-less response. I like to use the knife and fork God gave me. I just find cutlery a bit excessive. It reminds us of the clutter of life. Working from the outside in is just too much work. I'm not only saving dishes, I'm getting closer to the Lord.
Deep, right? Palagis love that.
Yeah, if you could tie any excuse back to climate change, yeah, you're winning. Unless they're a bunch of climate change deniers. But what are you, Republican?
Yeah. Also, if you get asked to do the blessing of the food, especially if they're really hungry, you can take your time.
Bruh.
Yeah. You played with them with the cutlery thing, then you can play with them for the blessing for the food as well. Even if it's gibberish, because they won't understand. Amen.
Okay guys, don't go away.
It's after the break, it's this guy's world.
Oh, life was pretty tough, to be honest. I grew up in Tonga. One day this fella come in to work and look for me. And I was like, oh, hey, I'm Loni. I was like, oh, hey, I got a scholarship to go to Auckland for school if you want. So school and then ring me the next week. So got a scholarship to Sekuhad.
Tai Nui.
Tai Nui.
Bro, I got a sore back, man. Can you give me a massage? Yeah, of course, anything for the brother.
I mean, it's sore is.
Hey, shh. I'm trying to ease your pain.
Malo lele, my name is Loni Uhila, aka the Tongan Bear. Welcome to my world. Life was pretty tough, to be honest. I grew up in Tonga, in the main island. A village called Alaki Fonua. My only mum at home and tried so hard to look after me and my brothers and sisters. A whole neighborhood was look after me and my family. And to be honest, when I come back from school, because I was with a fit kid at village, it doesn't matter if it's breakfast, lunch or dinner, people always yell out, Loni, come taste food. And then I never say no. Always get full by the time I get home anyways. I was the screw up, play a little bit of footy back home. One day this fella come in to work and look for me. And I was like, oh, hey, I'm Loni. I was like, oh, hey, I got a scholarship to go to Auckland for school if you want. And I was like, hey, are you serious or are you mucking around? I was like, oh, no, I'm serious. He was supposed to be my mate, Mr. Lili Pagauta, who was in Japan at the moment. I wasn't really keen on coming. So I was like, oh, yeah, fill up the form and all that. The school and then ring me the next week. So got a scholarship to Sekuhad. It was pretty fast and I'm always grateful for him. and always thought if I ever got a son one day, I'll name it after him. So I named my son after him, Isilele. He's a very good man, and he always been a special man in my life, because without him, I'm sure I was still back at home. Family is everything for me. I got my wife Amanda and my 5-year-old daughter Lily and my 1-year-old son Isilele. What I do at the moment is for my family. It just makes me trying to do better in life and make them happy and make them proud of me. Back at home, Christmas time, like, you know, birthday, Christmas, Easter, we don't have presents, stuff like that. So for my kids, that's why I'm trying to work hard. They get presents and Christmas card and stuff, but not going to spoil them. I always want to share with their niece and nephew back in Tonga, my sister's kids, and hopefully to take them home and see where I grew up and see life was pretty tough growing up. Hopefully that's what make them want to work hard one day to do the same for their family. I was never being a boxer, never fight on the street, never nothing. I used to go do some boxing in our village back home. I normally go there, put the gloves on, throw some haymakers with my brother, or with my older brother, Saya. And then the Butter Bean fight, I remember him calling up anyone in Auckland when he was on his first fight. And I was like, "Fuck, this fella is big, man. I'm never gonna fight him, I'm never gonna challenge him." And then he fought John Alomu's brother. After the fight, I was just making me angry. I was like, man, I want to fight this dude. Lost the fight. People thought that I won their fight. I don't think so. Butter Bean was better that night. Yeah, they called a rematch, and I say yes. I don't know why I say yes, to be honest.
The Bear looks like he's in pretty good shape. He just signed that Super Rugby contract with Hurricane.
I won it. I think we're going to have another rematch. We haven't said anything yet, but he's doing a good thing at the moment, training people up in Auckland, so big up to him and what he's doing. And but if it come, I'll take it. Just want to let all the young Tongan and young Polynesian out there keep working hard. One day you get there. I'm not there yet. I'm still trying. I'm still trying to get there. And don't give up. Just keep going.
Let me show you how to do it.
Alright, stay close, because one person who knows about food is Aunty Tala.
Yeah, she needs the A-week challenge.
Don't be sad to Aunty Tala. She only got big bones.
Yeah!
Che. Leave Auntie alone.
Thank you. Thank you for that.
We got big bones. Me and Auntie have big bones.
The only good thing culture dancing is free. The twerking that you're watching, you're paying for. So stop it.
Manu.
Ko.
Manu ko.
Oh, kia ora kare. How are you, kia? That's a nice one. Yeah, did you get the boil up on Megan? Oh, yeah. That's a good one. Yeah. We're going up to the government. Manu, go. Go to your room. Manu, go.
Savali Vali means go for a walk. Tau Tala Tala means too much talk. Alofa yate oi meet, I love you. Take it easy, fly, fly, lemu.
Guys, do you guys know what his last word mean in Tongan?
No.
You guys better go see Aunty Tala, because you just hit my feelings.
And welcome back to our Tau Tala Tala Show. where you tell us about your problem, and myself and my panel will help solve it. And I've got an all-star panel today. We've got one of my favorite singers and part of the modern Māori quartet. Please give it up for Matariki Matarau. And also, how can I forget the one and only Queen of Samoa, Cindy of Samoa! Yes, and also one of my ex-boyfriend, and he produced my album as well, and I still haven't heard it, but also part of Ill Semantics and Lyrical Music. Please put your hands together for Mark Aronma! Just my babies. Now, for the main part of our program, this is a very interesting question we got from our first video.
Hi, Aunty Tala. I wanted to know why some girls can twerk but can't hula or do their own traditional dance.
Wow, that's a very interesting question. Because, I mean, for me, I'm more, you know, very cultural. I'd like to see the star more. But what do you think about that, especially you being young, Matariki, about, you know, girls twerking and, but they can't do their traditional dance?
Well, look, no, I think it's about identity. Like, who do you identify yourself as? If you're Samoan, or if you're a Cook Islander, or if you're a Fijian, you should know a little bit about how to move it.
Yeah, how to move it.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, can you move it? Well, Cindy, you are a very popular entertainer. What are your thoughts about, because you do a lot of old school, new school. What do you think about that
question? Yeah, I have to do, on stage nowadays, you know, you can't just go there and stand there and sing. It's very boring. People want entertainment. So you got to twerk.
Yeah.
You got to do a tradition thing. You got to shake your money maker. Shake what your mother gave you, you know.
Can you show, what I don't understand it.
Oh, honey, don't make me twerk over here. This too will disappear.
Oh, no, I know that Mark sees a lot of it, but what, can you show, I've never seen it, this thing before.
Oh, you know,
can
it's you like that, yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah, that's how I twerk.
Wow.
Yeah.
Is that right, Mark?
That's right, Mark, say yes.
Very interesting.
Mm. So what are your thoughts about this? You know, do you think that if you're going to learn to twerk, that you should also know your own cultural type of dancing?
I think there's a whole bunch of things that are happening here. Media plays a big part in it. Being of Cook Island descent, our girls know how to hula, how to dance, and Tahitians are very good at doing the hula as well. Most girls these days can identify more with twerking than they can with the hula, so it's a good question.
Yeah. Well, all of you, what great comments. But I guess the thing now is we really do want to help Nico. Now, Matariki, what would you like to say to help answer that question?
Well, my bro Nico, look, just embrace both. You gotta love twerking and love hula at the same time. Bring them together, you don't know what could happen.
Nico, you sound to me like you're a very old-fashioned, traditional island boy. You need to freshen up that mind of yours and get used to twerking, because you don't know what you're missing out on. Twerk, baby.
That was Cindy. Well, how about you, man?
Well, Nico, brother, if you see that happening where the sisters are not or don't identify too well with their island hula or culture, encourage them to do that as well as be an ambassador for twerking. Put them together and make some hits.
Make some hits.
Wow.
I like your choice of words, man. We've had some amazing feedback from our panel when Matariki talked about, you know, taking the best of both worlds, where Cindy talking about, you know, you need to modernize and get with the new. And then we had Mark who said, you know, this is the same thing as what they both said. So I guess what I'm trying to say to help you, Nico, is enjoy both worlds, but the only good thing cultural dancing is free. The twerking that you're watching, you're paying for. So stop it. So I hope that helps you, and you take care. See you next week, same time. Bye.
Been around the world, don't speak the language.
Does
not. I'm that flight that you get on.
Okay, guys, here's this week's Poly Postcard.
New York to Haiti.
Hola,
chicos, I'm Piazza, currently travelling South America. Coming up, I'm going to show you my highlights of the beautiful Argentina. Let's go. Bienvenidos, Argentina.
Vamos a pegarnos como animales. Si necesitas reggaetón, dale. Sigue bailando, mami, no pare.
Argentina is the second biggest country in South America with a population of around 42 million people. They have some amazing landscapes, glaciers, deserts, and the Andes mountain range. They are a people with a rich culture, character, and history. Like most other South Americans, they love football.
Apparently they have the best fans in the world.
And maybe the sexiest dance in the world, the tango. Something special you share with friends? Mate o tereré?
Mantenelo fresco.
There's so many things I love about this place. If you come here, you have to try the steak and the wine. You have to learn tango. You have to go exploring the beautiful cities and landscapes. Honestly, there's so much here for people to see. So, what are you waiting for? Argentina and the world awaits. Ciao, ciao.
Okay, hope you've enjoyed kicking with us, the Hurricanes.
Malo pita mo lava magi felesi, tau tuk siyo.
And don't forget, always keep it felesi!
It's me, Lady Sick. I've got my cousin Mahalia here. Like a star
across my sky. Here in Melbourne to show you guys around. We've got a gig tonight, so I'm stoked.
Supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand on air.